The first one is to introduce two very different BIM meetings. Let's take a look at a couple of BIM meetings. So last week, apparently, Frank and Ted had BIM meetings with their clients. So they were sitting with their owners and having a meeting with them. And they both used the same agenda.
Yeah, both agendas were pretty good. They were,
determined to
find the BIM uses, you know, determine a lot of the information that's required, agree on what teams should be involved. So many...
What the milestones are, what the geometry, the documentation, the information.
Many topics to go through, but
pretty detailed.
Like it's well covered.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So let's meet Frank.
Yeah, let's see how Frank's meeting went.
Oh, he doesn't look so pleased.
Yeah, he looks overwhelmed, maybe.
So what do you think was the response from his client?
Well, let's take a look.
So Frank's client, they don't look so engaged, and maybe he lost them, you know, partway through this meeting.
Looks like a lot of my meetings in the past.
Yes, I can identify with that as well.
Frank's meeting, either side, by the way.
Been on both sides of
both.
It's a learning experience both ways.
I'm sure we have all had that.
And so, should we see how Ted got on?
Let's see how Ted's went. Whoa. This is Ted. Looks like his has been...
His went okay, yeah. It looks like it went okay. So Ted's client,
they're
applauding,
happy.
They're pleased.
He's pretty happy. His clients
are
pretty
happy. Dancing on the table?
Yeah.
Okay. So Ted's meeting was pretty different to Frank's meeting. So what could have been the cause for those differences?
Let's take a look. There's many of what could have caused Frank's to go bad.
Okay.
So let's take a look at those. So